QuickBooks Online 2022, bank feeds matching sales receipt. Get ready because it's go time with QuickBooks Online 2022. Here we are in our bank feed practice file. We set up with a 30-day free trial, holding down control, scrolling up a bit to get to the 125% currently in the home page, otherwise known as the Get Things Done page. The business view as compared to the accounting view. Switching to the accounting view is something you can do by going to the cog up top. Switch to the accounting view down below. We will be toggling back and forth between the two views either here or by jumping to the sample company file currently in the accounting view. Back on over to the bank feed practice file, opening up a few tabs to put reports in. Right clicking the tab up top and duplicating it. Back to the tab to the left, right clicking again and duplicating again as those are thinking. Let's see where the reports are located over in the accounting view. They're on the left hand side under reports. If we go back to the business view, then in the second tab, let's see where the reports are located in the business view. They're in the business overview. And then in the reports, I'm going to close up the hamburger. I'm speaking a little bit slow because I'm letting my computer think. As you can see, it's got the little circle up here. It's thinking. I'm going to go down and then say we want the balance sheet. Opening up the big balance sheet. I know it's a shock. It's a surprise. I just chose it randomly this time. Let's look at the balance sheet this time. 01012123121 on the range change and run. Tab to the right. What other report should we look at? I don't know. Closing the hamburger. Let's do the income statement. The profit and loss. Let's check that one out. Range change up top from 01012121 to 123121 and run. Opening up the bank feeds. Let's go to the first tab to check that out. That's where our focus is, bank feed stuff. Going down to the bookkeeping on the left-hand side. In the transactions up top to find the banking information where the bank feeds are located. If, by the way, you were in the accounting view, it would be located in the banking tab and then in the banking section. And so I'm going to go back on over. This is where the bank feed limbo is, as I call it. QuickBooks doesn't call it that, but they should because, you know, that's a good name for it. But this is where the bank feeds have been pulled in from the bank account and they have not yet been added to the promised land of the financial statements. They need a little help, a little love, a little guidance, a little information, which includes at least the account that we would have to record, as well as possibly a vendor and a customer. So we're now going to be jumping on over to our flow process. Let's look at our flow chart over here. This is the desktop flow chart, but we're just looking at it to see what the flow is. The forms will be the same so we can see what we're doing with the bank feeds. So we've talked about like a situation where we're dependent on the bank. We looked at then the invoice situation and accrual kind of component and put the bank feeds into every component along the way. Now we're going to look at a cash-based system where are not relying specifically on the bank feeds and we're using instead what QuickBooks would like us to use, which is the create sales receipt, which is often good because that can give us a little bit more detail as we record, but it'll be a little bit more difficult, be one more step than just waiting till something clears the bank to record it. Obviously, you might need to be using the create sales receipt if you're at something like a register, you're collecting multiple sales and you would like to record the sales of multiple sales at this point in time, possibly then grouping those sales together and depositing them into the bank in one lump sum, which then you would basically make the deposit over here in such a way that you expect it to also be in the same amount on the bank statement. So there's two ways that we could basically fit the bank feeds into a use of the create sales receipt. One is that we can create the sales receipt here, for example. Actually, there might be three ways. We can create the sales receipt item here, and then we can either put it at this point in time into the checking account, directly into the checking account, or we can put it into the clearing account, which used to be called undeposited funds. Now it's called something to be deposited or something like that. If you put it into the clearing account, you would be doing that because generally you would then need to be grouping those deposits together possibly and then putting it into the bank at one lump sum, or you might be doing that because you would like to then use the bank feeds to match out to the create sales receipt and basically have maybe a double check pulling the information out of hitting the journal entry, taking it out of undeposited funds, and making the actual deposit. So that's what we'll practice recording here at this point in time. We're going to create the sales receipt, and we're going to put the bank feed in place to match up to the sales receipt. We're not going to deposit it into the bank as we create the sales receipt. We could do that and then match out the deposit to it. The deposit then not recording anything new at that point in time, but matching out to what we have already done. Or we can create the sales receipt and put it into the clearing account, used to be called undeposited funds, now funds to be deposited or something like that. And then we can create the deposit from the bank feeds, matching it out to there, which would basically record the deposit, taking it out of the clearing account and putting it into the checking account. Now note that we're not gonna do the other method right now, which would be that you create multiple sales receipts, then deposit them, and then use the bank feeds to match out to the deposit. Why? Because we basically already saw that, because it would be the same process as we saw with the create sales receipt and receive payments. And then we have multiple receive payments that we put together and then make the deposit. And then we simply match out the deposit to the bank feed at that point not recording anything new, just simply verifying that we have made the recording of the deposit. So we've seen a similar kind of thing there. So this time we'll create the sales receipt, we'll put it into the clearing account, which used to be called undeposited funds, and then we'll match it out, the clear deposit on the bank feeds, that is, to move it from undeposited funds, or whatever it's called now, funds to be deposited, the clearing account, into the checking account with a deposit form that will be created with the bank feeds. Okay, hopefully that made some sense. I'm gonna go back on over here. We're gonna use the amount of this one here, 140, this was from Amazon, but we're just gonna imagine that it's gonna be a payment that we're gonna be receiving for our practice problem purposes. So I'm gonna work this backwards again. I'm gonna create the sales receipt, kind of going back in time as if that happened first, and then match this out to it. So this is $1.40, so I'm gonna make a sales receipt for $1.40. I'm gonna right click on the tab up top to do it, duplicating it. And then in here, I'm gonna hit the plus button on the left-hand side. I'm gonna hit that one, not too hard though, I don't wanna break it. And then I'm gonna go in here and we're gonna say that this is gonna be the sales receipt form, going into the sales receipt. It's thinking, let's make another customer, another generic customer. Customer, what am I on now? Customer number 8. Number 8, we got lots of customers. We don't even take their name. They're just a number to us here. It's kind of impersonal. We're going to say save it. And let's say this happens on like 4/1/2021, making sure I got that right this time. Get it in the right year, could you? Would you mind if you put it in? Then we're gonna put it into the payment to deposit instead of into the checking account. So we could put it in the checking account at this point in time. If we were to do so, we can then use the deposit form. I mean, we could use the bank fee transaction to match out to what we had already done, no new transaction being recorded. Or we can put it into the payments to deposit form area, which used to be called undeposited funds, which is usually used to then take multiple sales receipts, group them together in the same format as they're going to be grouped together when we go into the bank. For example, if you had multiple cash sales, you're going to put them together and deposit them in the bank at one time. You want the same thing to happen on your side. But in our case, we're going to imagine that this will hit the bank for the same dollar amount we're going to put in here, which will be the $1.40. But we're going to put it into the clearing account so that we can use the deposit form to kind of from the bank feeds to give us that kind of double check, taking it out of this clearing account and then putting it into the bank. Okay, so let's do it then. This is gonna be service one, no inventory involved, no sales tax involved. This will be for $1.40, big sale here made. Who made that sale? We gotta make sure someone collects the commission on that one. Someone's gonna want that. So any case, this is going to increase then the undeposited funds, which is now payment to deposit. The other side's going to go into sales. Let's save it and close it and check it out. Save it and close it. Tab to the right and then run it again. Freshen it up. Heat that thing up. Put it in the oven for a little bit because it got cold. And then we're going to go down and say that we're going to have to say that this increased the payments to deposit. It used to be called undeposited funds, the clearing account, the holding account. And there it is in the $1.40, the buck 40, the buck 40. And then I'm going to go back on over the other sides on the income statement, going to the income statement, holding down control, scrolling down. And we could see in the service area, there we have our services. And we got the buck 40. Now, doing this method is also useful, and it might be something that you think about doing to give you some more information as well. Because if I wait till something clears the bank and I don't use the sales receipt form, I don't get as much detail sorting my income accounts by, say, item, and I don't get as much detail to basically sort my customer information. So, for example, if I go to the first tab here and I go into my get paid and paid area, and then into the customers, which if you were in the accounting view would be on down into the sales side of things, and then into the customers, and I go into that customer number, what am I on, eight right there. If you go into that one, then you actually see the sales receipt. If we didn't use a sales form, in other words, we didn't use an invoice or sales receipt, but just recorded the sale with a deposit as it cleared the bank, then we don't get kind of this added detail. You can also run reports by the item here. So you can actually break out and get more detail about what you're selling by the items you're selling if you're using the sales receipt as opposed to entering the sales with a deposit form. So for example, if I went to the business overview and went into the report area, and then I could say I want to have like a sales report, sales by item, sales by type detail, sales by product or service detail. Let's do that one. And so now I can break out my sales with the range change 010121 to 123121 and run it. And I could get a breakout of what I'm actually selling by the things that I'm selling, which you can't do if you're just recording the sales by the deposit form, because it doesn't have the items in the deposit form to track that added detail. Might not be a problem for you. You might not need that added detail, but just something to consider. Let's go to the tab to the left. Let's use our bank feed now. Now, oftentimes, if I was to like refresh this, the system might be able to match it automatically and say, oh, I see $1.40 here, and I see that there's a deposit for $1.40, and it would probably match it out for you, or is much more likely to, because it has the dollar amount and the date, the dates being a little off in our example problem, but that often is enough for it to basically be able to match them out. So, but in any case, I'm gonna go ahead and say find, not, did I say find? Hold on a sec, I'm gonna close this out. I want to go to, now I lost it, now it's gone, $1.40, and I want the match. Yeah, that's what I want, find match. I did it right. What was that worrying about? I don't know. Let's make this back to one, and there, and then down here, there's the $1.40 we want. $1.40, checking it off. This is a sales receipt that went into the clearing account, so this is going to record a deposit, taking it out of the clearing account, which used to be undeposited funds, but it's now something to deposit or something like that, and put it into the checking account. So let's save it and close it and check it out and see if that is indeed what it does. Is that indeed what it does in like deed form, the way it in deeds? I don't like just talk, man. I want to see the deeds. So I'm going to go back in here, run it, and scroll down and see if that is what it does indeed. Going into the checking account and say, let's see it. Let's see it. And this was $1.40. There's the $1.40. Deposit has been made. If I go into that $1.40, the buck 40, there it is. Bank deposit form that has been entered and generated from the bank feed. Closing it back out, going back up top, going back then to our report. The clearing account used to be called undeposited funds, now called, what's it called again? Payment to deposit. That one that I can't remember ever, but I will. I'll get it. I'll forget it like 200,000 more times, and then it'll click. There'll be a click that you can audibly hear from a mile away in my head. and then I'll never forget it again. I don't know what I'm talking. So there's the $1.40 in any case. There's the $1.40 done, back down to zero on the clearing account. So there we have another method where the sales receipts can kind of fit in a bit more complex method than just depending on the bank feeds, depending on the type of industry you are in.